Hey everyone, welcome back to The Road to Superman. This is the web series where we follow all the latest updates and rumours regarding the Superman reboot. This is episode 25, which means we are a quarter of the way to episode 100. And I really wonder what we will be talking about when we hit the 100th episode of the web series. Hopefully by that time we should be breaking down a Superman trailer or something like that. But anyway, what have I got for you guys today regarding the Superman movie? Well, we have some casting news for more Daily Planet characters, as well as some set photos that definitely give us a hint as to what Lex Luthor is up to. So let's get into the updates. Firstly, we start with the news that Beck Bennett is joining the Daily Planet crew as Steve Lombard. This was first reported by The Hollywood Reporter and then confirmed by James Gunn. Now, I only know him from SNL, and he is quite funny, which matches the character who he will be portraying in Superman. Steve Lombard is a notoriously arrogant character which tends to be used as comedy, and I think that will play right into Gunn's hands. And I hope, because he is using a comedic character, it means that he won't need the other characters to be comedians as well, as Lombard will be the perfect comedic contrast within the Daily Planet. Our next piece of casting news is from The Hollywood Reporter as well, who states Michaela Hoover and Christopher McDonald have been cast as Cat Grant and Ron Troop, which means the Daily Planet cast is stacking up. We have a total of 7 characters just within the Daily Planet, and obviously their screen time will vary. For all we know, Cat Grant could just be seen on a TV for like 5 seconds or so, and Ron Troop the same. So don't be alarmed at the size of the cast. Now, with Cat Grant being a part of the Daily Planet, we could be seeing some form of love triangle, as Cat has been known to be a love interest of Clark's. Maybe she's interested in Clark, but Clark only sees eyes for Lois, or maybe she will just be there to set up her more prominent role in Supergirl, a bit like how she was in the Supergirl CW show. And the reason why she appears in Superman is to just keep continuity strong, going from Superman to Supergirl. But now moving on to set photos. These were taken by OBV Photography at Mentor Headlands Beach a few days ago. Now, a lot of these photos make it look like there is a basic army camp where some soldiers will be based or something along those lines, but one photo revealed that these are connected to Nicholas Holt's Lex Luthor. On the side of one of the barrels is the name Luthor Corp. Now, firstly, a bit strange they didn't go with Lex Corp, as that is the normal name for Luthor's company, but secondly, what are they doing there? It's interesting that they are based on a beach, and there were also 2 videos posted of some people doing a fight rehearsal too. I won't post the videos in this video, as I don't want to risk getting the video or channel taken down, so I will leave a link in the description below to see them. Now, from what I can see, none of them are main cast members, but these could be their stunt doubles. It seems to be a lot of hand-to-hand combat, so no clear sign of someone with powers, so I don't really know who this could be. Now, moving on to Kent Farm, we do have a new photo from DC Film News of our new Kent Farm. Now, if you remember my previous video about the farm, you will remember that I didn't love the new house, but didn't outright reject it, and how a lot of fans overreacted to what I said. But now we have a new photo of Kent Farm, and I actually really like it from this shot. We can see that there is a red barn, and I think the overall look of Kent Farm looks so much better than the original badly taken photos, which was bound to be the case, but that doesn't mean I can't form an opinion on the original photos. I think the issue that many had with my comment on the last photo was that many assumed that me saying I didn't think it looked the best was my final opinion on the farm, and it could never change. And I think that is more of a commentary on how social media reacts to opinions now. People act as if opinions can't change, and whatever a person says is exactly how they will feel for the rest of their life. A lot of the time, that isn't the case, and it definitely isn't the case with me. But so yeah, I really like the look of Kent Farm from these new photos, and through an IMAX camera, I'm sure they will look even better. And finally, on today's episode of Road to Superman, we need to look at some more fantastic art from Will Rios. He has created this stunning artwork of Superman hovering in the sky, and I have to say once again, why on earth was a shot like this not used as our first glimpse at Superman? I know I keep on going on about it, but this shot here makes the suit look so much better. But instead of thinking about it like that, I'm going to try and think, wow, there is so much potential with this suit. I love the design, I just don't like how it fits Corin Sweat in that one official angle of the suit. But I've seen all the fan art of our official suit in different poses, and it proves that the suit can and most likely will look great in the movie. And by Gunn releasing the image he did, it means it can only go up from there, and I can't wait to see how the suit really looks officially when he is standing up. But great work from Will Rios, who has made me very excited to see an official flying shot of Superman. But that is all for today's episode of The Road to Superman. Thank you so much for watching. Please make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on post notifications so you never miss an episode. I hope to see you here again soon, so until then, have a great day. Bye!